fucking mics in front of your face. They ask you to rap, nigga.
Best freestyle home in Rochester. No other freestyle podcast better.
Spot in the rock with the raps never stop. Welcome back to Balanced Perspective.
As an artist, you gotta be prepared at all times. Oh, I ain't putting on no headphones. I want to hear the beat straight up. Yeah. Look. You crush your dog out for a half a pie. I put my dog onto a half a pie for half the price and told him make it back in time. We airing shit out, crossing all our T's like if we praying to God and dotting all our I's so we won't miss the chance of being the odds. I come up from the bottom. When you ain't promised to make it out alive, it's either jail or death. But if you like me, you gon' choose survive. I put that on my mother. When niggas see me, they on bro time. Cause 9 times out of 10, if they deceive me, I'm on go time. You know I never been too friendly. I just show respect, that's why these niggas.
What I said, hold up.
Hold up, man. Hold on. Let me run it back. What I said, I never been too friendly. I just show respect. That's why they never cross me. If niggas try me, then I'm on they neck. The same nigga pull up to my block and pull my hood up. I have your homies crying on y'all block, throwing y'all hood up. Let's go to war, I'm with it. I just copped another Harley jammer. Baking soda shit. The niggas round me keep an arm with hammers. You ain't gonna do shit. My youngin' Riley will come and carve your grandma. Killer in the mist. Shit, it be times that boy get hard to handle. Praying for my sins.
Hold up.
Mm-hmm.
Yo, it's the guy Luca. Welcome back to Balanced Perspective, the platform where we put you on. Shout out to Fam Studio for allowing us to do this tonight. We got another 3-minute freestyle, but first we want to allow our artist to introduce himself.
It's your boy CashWitUs Pooh. You already know CashWitUs CNT Trap Gang Movement. Know what I mean? RP to the beast. We the realest niggas in the streets. Freedom on all platforms. Make sure y'all go get that, man. You already know what it is.
Freedom.
Fire. Crazy.
Yo, first of all, I want to congratulate you on the new album drop.
Appreciate you.
It's really lit. I've been on doing, follow me on TikTok too. I've been doing a lot of workout videos and shit to his music. Going crazy.
Yeah, you gonna get y'all buff to that.
That's a fact. Hey, yo, it's some real gutter shit though. Like, I can't hold you. That shit really put me in a mode.
I'm really
like,
talking to them niggas
really
on that shit.
That shit really put me in a mode. I love it though. I love it, man.
I'm hurting their ass on every song, son.
Yo, pain. Straight pain.
I got something for everybody on there. I got something for the women. I got something for the street niggas. I got something for the niggas as bosses.
Facts,
the plugs.
Facts, though.
All
facts.
That niggas who in jail who about to come home.
Hey, yo. He said, when they put me in that cell, I got closer to God.
More,
dog. Yeah.
Hey, yo, look, you know what's crazy? This is the first interview that I did since being home from jail. So.
Word?
Mm-hmm.
Why?
This is the first one.
Why?
Because, man, I was sitting back focusing, trying to get my shit straight. Mm-hmm. Put me out of the whole case I'm fighting, you know what I'm saying? I gotta maintain that shit other than just music. But I've been making some new music. I kind of stayed low from that shit for a minute.
Yeah, I noticed that shit just popped out of nowhere.
Yeah.
Nah, I was just popped out of nowhere. I'm just like,
man, what?
So I find it and I'm like, all right, cool, let me give it a listen. I start listening, I'm like, who the fuck is this? Like, who the fuck is this? I listen to the first track, Freedom. I'm like,
yeah.
Oh shit, who the fuck? Yo, this Jada?
Crazy.
Then I get to the track. I get to the track. And this man got an intro from Jada. And I'm just like, oh, cuz on.
Yeah,
he
facts.
Oh, like he doing it. Nigga, he doing that. Yeah, yeah. That's what I want to hear. But I honestly, I appreciate and I admire like your talent. You feel me?
Appreciate
your
it,
voice.
Man.
Like I said, you got that raspy, that pain voice. And yeah. Jada, my favorite artist.
And you know what's crazy is that this is my real voice. You hear me? This
is my real voice.
I only sound like that.
Niggas not
music.
Getting on the track and start screaming. They not screaming at me. He not Meek Milling it.
This is my real voice.
Nah, that's fact.
I done had people ask me like, yo, son, you get on the track and change your voice to sound like and I'm like, nah, man, it's real hard talk. It's my voice.
Barry White, son. But nah, man. So how do you got that intro, first of all, from Jada? You want to talk about that first.
So it's crazy how Jada came across me out of nowhere, son. Like, but from what I know is that he been watching me for a long time. You know what I mean? And funniest part about it is that I dropped I dropped a video. It's called Half Man, Half Beast. Right? That was back in, what, 20... Was that 2020? And that same year, son, he found me. He found me months later, though. He found me in, like, October, son. And it's crazy because around the time when he found me and shit, like, it was somebody who was showing me a video like, yo, Jada bumping and shit. Like, he felt that. That's he sent fire. It to me.
Wait,
and
somebody sent you a video of Jada bumping
my shit. Nigga. And I was like, oh, shit. Like, hold up. Like, nah, this real, though. Like, yeah, yo, I mean, this Kiss, bro. Yeah, like, yeah. Nah, I mean, this is my favorite rapper, too. Like, whole time. Like, I got a lot of rappers that I listen to, but, like, I grew up listening to Kiss. Like, that's my favorite rappers, yo. You know what I mean? Especially when it comes to like flows and bars and shit. They taught me all of that. You know what I mean?
Yo, if I was to rap, niggas might not catch me rapping, but if Jada reach out to me, I'm gonna rap. I got some shit written. Just know, if Jada reach out to me, I'm rapping. Yeah. Just know, nigga, I'm here.
And look, it's wild because right after I had seen the video, I looked on Instagram and he was commenting on all my shit. And I was like, hold up. Like, nah, this real. Like,
how that shit feel? I know that had to be like a...
Yo, I'm not even gonna hold you, son. It's crazy because he was commenting on all my shit. And then when I, like, he never direct messaged me. He never just messaged me.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Until the next day, I woke up to a message to him.
So you probably thought that shit was like a...
I thought it was like somebody like bullshit.
I've been hating him since.
Yeah, I thought it was fake. And then out of nowhere, like, I had talked to him. You know what I'm saying? Like, I talked to him face to face on the grin, on live, and I'm like, oh shit, like this Kiss. I sent him my flowers instant. I'm like, yo, bro, thank you for everything. Like, nigga, for your raps, your music, all that. Like, nigga, if it wasn't for no Kiss, bro, I probably wouldn't even be doing this shit.
Yo, it's crazy because I could see like how much he influenced you, but I can also see how much of yourself you put in that shit.
Yeah.
And that's the beauty of it, like the art, you feel me? Like, I can see all that shit, and it's crazy, man. We always talk about, like, I'm gonna ask you this question, and it's, who's your top five? And I'm gonna say top five artists.
You know, it's crazy, my top five change all the time.
And that's perfect, because that goes right back to what I was gonna say. Like, we always ask that question, but like how you admire Jada, everybody admires somebody.
Yeah.
It started, like, history, like, that shit started before us, my bad. Like,
right.
And then, like, we grew up listening to somebody, and then the person we grew up listening to was growing up listening to somebody else.
You know what
then,
I'm saying? So it's like, everybody got their own top
five. It's so crazy, but it's the beauty of the art,
right? Right.
It's like that brushstroke, that brushstroke, and you gonna see that brushstroke in a bunch of different paintings, but you're gonna tell, like, that motherfucker came from that one artist.
Hey, yo, I can't even hold you, son. If we really talking about top fives, like, I'm going to definitely put myself in my top five.
As you should.
I'm my favorite rapper.
As you should.
I'm not about to sit here and try to put somebody over. I am my favorite rapper.
As you should.
You feel me? But if we talking about outside of just myself, if we talking about, like, legend-wise or, like, you know what I'm saying, like, who I bump on the daily outside of my, like, my own music.
I'll say who inspires you the most.
Kiss. Oh, for sure. Kiss. Him and Wayne.
Him and Wayne?
Him and Wayne. Kiss and Wayne. Them two right there inspire me the most. Like, a lot of people, because I got two different types of top fives. I got top fives of old, and I got top fives of, you know what I'm saying, legends of, like, who paid the way for us type.
I respect you.
So, like, if we talking about old, Pun is one of my favorite rappers, bro. Pun is in my top five.
I can see that.
Yeah.
I can see that.
Pun is definitely
in
my top five.
Yeah, I can see that.
You got Rakim.
Okay, I can see that.
You got Big Daddy Kane.
Oh, my
God. Got Big L. And then you got, who the other one? Jesus. I'm not going to hold you. It'll probably have to be... Yo, that's crazy. How I lose my top five old niggas. That's wild.
If you like that.
It's too many.
It's too many.
I really don't know now, son. That's like a top four. Yeah.
Top five. And Kiss, of course.
Right. But if we talking about, like, of, like, our generation, for sure, Kiss is my number one. That's my number one, bro. Feel me? After Kiss, come Hov. To me. Then... I'm not gonna lie, Wayne is, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, of the newer generation coming up, Wayne was, you know what I'm saying?
No, that's a fact. That's
but
a fact.
We
all know that.
Nas, Lyrical wise, Nas, of course.
Oh, God.
Nas. And then you got J. Cole. J. Cole is a...
Cole deserved to be in anybody's top five. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. Fact. He deserved it, though. He earned it.
He earned the spot for that.
Different.
Definitely, bro.
Cole different, man. So, like, when you started rapping, like, when you started actually...
Like, actually taking it serious?
Yeah.
I was 18.
18?
Mm-hmm. But I've been rapping since I was 8, but I suck. I did. Back then, I sucked. Man, I'm not gonna lie.
I think we all did.
Yeah, we was young, trying to come up rapping.
Yeah. The lack of vocabulary.
But mind you, back in the day, even when I was 8 trying to rap, it was kids who was like 10, 12 years old who was fire. You feel me? Like, it's just like sometimes, like, that gift is blessed to, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? It's blessed to people early.
Like the average battle rappers, like the average, we're gonna say video scene rappers that we seen growing up.
Right.
Them niggas was like 18.
Yeah.
Like Reed Dollars, I mean like
16 and up.
Yeah, 16 and up.
16 and up, bro.
Really just like that. Even Jada, when he started, he was 16 and up.
He was 16 and up.
All the niggas started young. All them niggas started young.
But them niggas looked, they're so grown, bro.
It's crazy.
You would have thought them niggas was in their 20s.
Yo, nigga, listen. Hey, yo. We knocking the 30 piece down. Crazy, right? So listen, like when we was younger and we used to look at that shit, we think like Pac got killed at 24 and shit. Like, nigga, like just think about that shit. Like, damn, that's young as a bitch.
That's mad young.
That's mad young. Nigga.
Especially like, me, I'm 28. So 3 years younger than me, Pac got killed at. That don't make no sense.
I remember when I was that age, I was young, just like, man. I was looking over my shoulder at all times. Just, I had that fear, like don't be a menace. You know what I mean? Like they were saying, like, you don't make it. You don't make it after a certain age. Like, I really was, yo, that shit had me worried. I'm not gonna hold you. That shit really.
The beginning part of the movie is scared the shit out you.
It's crazy, bro. When I was young, I didn't see myself living past 24. It was weird because I didn't know.
Yo, I didn't realize
like how young that was. I didn't realize, you know what I mean? Like the age.
The road niggas was taking at that time, I didn't even see myself making it to 21. So. I remember being 18 years old, scared as a bitch that I wasn't gonna reach age 21. And I would tell my mom, like, Mom, like, you think I'm going to live until I'm 21? And my mom used to be like, boy, stop talking like that. Like, you talking crazy. But I really was shook because, like, the shit that was going on around us, the shit we was out here doing, you know what I'm saying? It scared the nigga. Like, even though, like, you know what I'm saying? Say, even though we was scared, nigga still was doing it.
You know how much of that shit that we was, like, it was the fight or flight, you feel me?
Mm-hmm.
So, like, we was feared into it, but we grew through it. So we grew that strength.
And niggas had to do it.
But it was so much shit, like, now we look back at that shit like it's normal. Like, we look at that shit like it's normal.
Damn,
like,
when you so young, it was, it meant something.
Yeah,
like, now
meant
you
like,
man,
the fuck going
normal
up?
Shit.
Like, yeah, fact. That's normal shit. Life, motherfucker. Like, that's it. But it's crazy, like, I don't know. I don't know if we should look at it like that or not. Like,
it's crazy, too, because I know a lot of young niggas nowadays who feel that same way. And they young. They like 18, 19, these niggas is doing anything to get a name, son. You know what I'm saying? Like, you got real deal serial killer little niggas that's young as a bitch. And then you got old niggas who would never do that.
Yeah. Got old niggas that are
like, old niggas so looking at them like,
down,
yo,
nigga.
Y'all niggas really sit out here
down,
doing that?
Nigga.
Like, damn, yeah. Scott. Like, for real.
For real.
Real shit. It's true, though, son.
So, speaking of the youth, what would you have to say to someone that's, like you said, you 18,
yo,
I'm thinking you about to make it to 21.
Yo,
what would you have to say
thing
to somebody
about
like
me,
that?
I got a special love for young children.
I noticed I said too.
Yeah.
Hey, yo. Hey, listen. Neighborhood dad, nigga.
Yeah.
For real. The neighborhood dad, nigga.
I love the kids.
For
man.
Real.
I love
nigga.
Them. They love me too. I pull up in my hood, them kids run up to my car. Like,
that's a fact,
yeah,
nigga. I witnessed it.
I witnessed it.
That shit crazy. Like, all the kids.
Like,
nigga,
look, yesterday.
15, 20 of these months.
Hey, yo, look, it's crazy because yesesterday, I broke down $100, right?
Uh-huh.
And you know, to a kid, son, like, you know what I mean? A kid that's like 10, 9, 11 years old. Nigga, $20 is like $100 to them.
That's a fact. Stress the fuck out of
you. You feel me? So what I did was, right, because it was a lot of the, like, man, it was a lot of kids. So what I did was I came downstairs, right, off of the balcony, and the kids see me, and he was like, kid, what up, kid? And I'm like, what up, y'all? You know what I'm saying? All the kids and shit. I love them. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
So kids run up to me like, yo, my birthday coming up, da da da. I'm like, well, where were your birthday? I'm like, I'm gonna have some money for you. Mm-hmm. One kid like, yo, you got some McDonald's money? I'm like, yo, this little nigga funny, son. He telling me his birthday today. He ain't really his birthday. So I'm like, I'm crying laughing. Yo,
kids funny as hell, bro.
Yo, nah, but on the real note, see, look, I always tell niggas, right? You do good deeds, you don't gotta record yourself doing it. You know what I'm saying? I always tell niggas that, because I do good deeds every day and I don't record shit. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of times I feel like when you don't record them, God gonna bless you even more just because of the fact that you ain't feel that need to have to do that. Like yesterday, I broke down $100. I gave all of the kids over there $10 each. I'm like, here, do. And I know what I told them after that. I said, all I want y'all to do for me is respect y'all parents and love one another. That's it. Now, if we have people like that to teach kids that more, and them kids gonna grow up perfect.
That's a fact.
Facts.
That's a fact.
We ain't had that shit growing up. Niggas like, yo.
We ain't have many folks like that. Man, we had some, but we ain't have many of them. And that's the thing, like, you right, but
it, facts.
Yo, I talk about the energy a lot. You feel me? I talk about the energy like it's light. So light can go through the dark no matter what.
Right.
Your energy, like, when you meet a person, that energy that you give off, that shit stick. You feel me? Like, you can't, if you would've came in here on some screw face, ready to, you know what I mean? Like, on demon time, that shit would've affected the room.
Exactly.
And then even when you left, it still would've affected us. You feel me?
Because it would've had y'all feeling like, damn, that nigga energy was off.
You feel me? So now, that would've been bad energy that we would've experienced from you. That's what we would've took from you. But you giving out good. All you give out is good.
Positive.
And that's it. That right there is, that. It's very contagious, and it's very, motherfuckers gonna hate that shit.
Oh yeah.
But that be like the reason you do it. You feel me? Like, you do that
see,
shit.
Look, you know what I tell niggas?
Like, that shit, like, yeah, I want that.
I always tell niggas this, right? Cause I'm a God fearing man, and I know people got their own beliefs, but I believe in God. I ain't afraid to talk about him either. Feel me? Shit, I walk around. Look, nigga, you could get this on camera. I walk around everywhere with a Bible on me. As you should. You know what I'm saying? I want to always stay highly favored and blessed. You feel me? But and that's my weapon. I don't need to be walking around with shit on me to, you know what I'm saying? That's my weapon. Facts. You feel me?
Say that shit for the
and I tell the word of God to people. You know what I mean? But anyway, I always tell people this, right? I always tell people that when you hold a positive image to yourself and another person don't like it, they got demons that they need to figure out, that they battling with. You know what I'm saying? And mind you, like, I'm not, and when I say I always tell people about God, I'm not the one to tell you, like, you need to believe him. You need to da-da-da. Nah, because I'm not going to force something on you that you don't want to do. That come with your own beliefs. You know what I'm saying? But I could tell you about the shit that God got me out of. You know what I'm saying? Even my situation now. You know what I'm saying? The situation I'm facing, a lot of niggas don't get the blessings that I done got.
That's a fuck.
You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to go too into it, but you know what I'm saying? I know for sure that he real, because he showed.
That's a fact. Always going
to show. Shit.
You always going
to show. Why whenever I come around, niggas feel the good energy. I'm smelling good. I'm talking to niggas. I'm like, yo, what up?
You know
what I'm saying?
I love it.
I always tell niggas, if you hate me, you hating yourself, because I don't give niggas a reason to. You feel me? That's just that. I don't give a nigga the reason to hate me. You know what I'm saying? To know me is to love me. If you hate me, that's your fault.
So who is Cam?
Me? I'm a loving soul. Yeah. I'm a loving soul. You know what I'm saying? I show respect to anybody and everybody. You know what I'm saying? If I show you respect and you don't give me the respect back, I'm never dealing with you again. I know how to peep and pull niggas away from, you know what I'm saying, my own space. I don't surround myself with people who don't show respect, because to gain respect, you gotta show it. You know what I'm saying? And just like in the words of my brother Turb, shout out my brother too, in the words of my brother always said, niggas talking about loyalty all the time. Fuck that, it's not about that. You gotta be a likable person for a nigga to even respect you, Scott. That's real shit. Facts. That's real shit. Because I mean, if you not like, who gonna respect you? Who even gonna be loyal to you if you not a likable person?
Thank you.
You feel what I'm saying?
Like, thank you. Hey, yo, said it best, man. I'm ready to hear the man. Hey, yo, welcome back to Balance Perspective, the platform where we put you on. Spotting the rock, the raps never stop. We got great guests,
CashWitUs Pooh, baby. You already know.
Hey, yo, plug them in real quick. Plug them in. Where they can reach you at, man?
Hey, yo, man. Y'all niggas can find me on Facebook, Kemi Wavy. You can find me on Instagram. I only got two social medias, and that's Instagram and that's Facebook. Snapchat, don't got it. Twitter, don't got it. You see a fake page, you know it ain't me. Instagram, CashWitUs_Pooh. I mean, y'all follow me, I'll follow all y'all back. I show love whenever love gets showed to me, you alright? And shit, man, all my music on all platforms, every streaming platform. It ain't one that you ain't gonna type in CashWitUs and I'm not gonna pop up. You know what I'm saying? So y'all make sure y'all stay tuned. And to the niggas that sleep, and I'm about to wake you niggas up in a minute. So y'all just make sure y'all keep y'all water on the side of y'all bed, you niggas asleep. Or I'm about to wake niggas up.
Facts. Yo, make sure y'all add us on YouTube, add us on Facebook, Balance Respective, fan podcast on YouTube. Hey,
yo, this crazy, yo. You know what's wild, bro? Is that this is the most comfortable interview I've ever been in. And hey, I done been in mad of them.
Man, speaking of that, man, it's the balance, baby, man. Yeah, so it's about, balance, man. It's my real, energy, yo. Man. I'm telling you, man, I'm all about energy, bro. Like, I'm a loving person. We family, nigga. We gonna put this shit out.
Niggas
we
don't
family.
Even know this we is family, my cousin. Like, this family. Is my blood cousin. Niggas like, don't even
it.
Know that.
It runs, man. That's how we was raised. You
facts.
Know? Like, we been through so much shit, but at the end of the day, like, that's some shit we went through. That's normal.
Yeah, nigga, that's normal. Family, nigga. Like, niggas that's don't normal, even know that. Nigga. Man.
Like, that's normal, and we love everybody. You feel me? Like,
facts.
That's what life about. And when you come up in here at Fan Studio, you're gonna be loved. Don't act stupid, because we can do that too.
Yeah, we're going to get like that.
You're going to be loved. And you know what I mean, we're going to get real balanced. We're going to share perspectives. Yeah, we're going to talk that shit. You're going to rap. I'm going to make you rap.
Yo, you
I'm
going to spit some shit. You come up in here. I'm going to spit some rap. Shit. Make but, that shit sound real crazy in this bitch too.
Pull up. Just pull up, man. Add us, man. Tag us. Share us. Like us. Do it all. We
that
love
nigga
y'all.
Marketing scheme's crazy. I gotta start saying that shit in my type of shit. Word, man. At me, nigga. Follow me, nigga. Bitch, I'm marketing everything. Fuck that. Oh, Ayo, saying another thing too. We just dropped some merch, man. CashWitUs clothing. You know what I'm saying? Y'all could get the clothing on CashWitUsClothing.com. You know what I'm saying? The website about to launch soon. And you know what I mean? We got flavors. We got mad different flavors. We got short sets, hoodies, shirts.
Make sure you send something up here for the fans.
Oh yeah, I got you for the free. You know that I send something up here for
we
you.
We gonna support, bro. You gotta tell us. It's all love.
Let's
support regardless, man. Bro. You take donations. You take donations, brother.
You know what I'm saying? Definitely right, got some merch for niggas, man.
All right, let's get into this shit, man. The spot in the rock with a rap never stop, man. Let's go.